Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hi everyone, welcome back to my English class. With me, Mrs. Winnie from SMPN 1 Ota Pesanggrahan 2 Batu. In this session, you are going to study Bahasa Inggris kelas 8 semester 2. You can take a look at on your textbook when English rings a bell on page 85. Today, we are going to study chapter 7, My Uncle is a Zookeeper. And the teaching objectives in this part is that to communicate states and events that happen routinely or as general truth. Jadi kita akan fokus pada pernyataan atau kejadian rutin yang dilakukan atau sebagai kebenaran umum. Okay, let's move on to the next slide. Now look at that picture. What animal do you see? Yes, that's right. They are an elephant, two deers, a tiger, a bear and a monkey. Now look at this animal. What animal is it? Yes, it's an elephant. Kita akan mempelajari empat hal. Yang pertama yaitu where is the habitat? Di mana tempat tinggalnya? Yang kedua, what are their food? Apa makanannya? Yang ketiga, what are their activity? Apa aktivitas atau kegiatannya? Kemudian yang keempat, what are their characteristics? Apa karakternya? Before we go on, please listen to my voice and repeat after me. Elephants are the heaviest land animal. They are also intelligent and have good memories. Most of them live in Africa and Asia, such as in Lampung, Indonesia. They use their long trunks almost like an arm to put food and water in their mouth. They eat grass and plants. From the text, we know that tempat tinggal elephant is in Africa and Asia, such as in Lampung, Indonesia. Kemudian, informasi yang kedua yaitu tentang food atau makanannya. What are their food? Yes. They eat grass and plants, yang artinya makanannya adalah rumput dan tumbuh-tumbuhan. Then, what are their activity? Excellent. They use their long trunks almost like arms to put food and water in their mouths. Gajah menggunakan belalainya yang panjang untuk meletakkan makanan dan air di mulutnya. Then, what are their characteristics? Bagaimana dengan karakteristiknya? Ya, benar sekali. Di sini disebutkan bahwa elephants are the heaviest land animal, yang artinya hewan darat terberat. Okay, let's look at this tiger. Before we go on, listen and repeat after my voice. Tigers are the biggest of all cats. They live in a grasslands and forests. Their striped coat gives them good camouflage when they hunt. They love meat to eat. Baik anak-anak, kita akan membahasnya bersama. Kita mulai dari habitatnya dulu ya. Where is the habitat? Di mana habitatnya? Okay, good. They live in grassland and forest, yang artinya mereka tinggal di padang rumput dan di hutan. Okay, let's go on to the next. What are their food? Apa makanannya? Yes, you're right. They love meat to eat, yang artinya mereka suka makan daging. Then, what are their activity? Bagaimana dengan aktivitasnya? Their striped coats give them good camouflage when they hunt, yang artinya bulu belangnya sangat membantu penyamaran ketika mereka sedang berburu. Kemudian, what are their characteristics? Yes, tigers are the biggest of all cats. Harimau adalah jenis kucing yang paling besar. Let's move on to the next slide and it's all about a bear. Before it, listen to my voice and repeat after me. Bears have thick fur coats to protect them from the cold. Most of them live in northern parts of the world. They are large and powerful. They have a good sense of smell. Some of them eat meat and some of them eat honey. In winter, some bears find a snug place to hibernate. Okay, Let's look at for the first, where is the habitats? Yes, that's true. Most of them live in northern parts of the world. Sebagian dari mereka hidup di bagian utara belahan dunia. Then, what are their food? Apa makanan mereka? Some of them eat meat and some of them eat honey. Sebagian dari mereka memakan daging dan sebagian lagi memakan madu. Then, what are their activity? In winter, some bears find a snug place to hibernate. Jadi, di musim dingin, beruang-beruang ini mencari tempat yang sempit untuk berhibernasi. Lalu, what are their characteristics? Ada banyak ya karakter si hewan ini. Yang pertama, bears have thick fur coats to protect them from cold. Yang artinya, beruang mempunyai bulu yang tebal untuk melindungi dirinya dari hawa dingin. Yang kedua, they are large and powerful. Yang artinya, mereka sangat besar dan sangat kuat. Yang ketiga, they have a good sense of smell. Artinya, mereka memiliki indera penciuman yang tajam. Baik anak-anak, apakah kalian sudah mengerti? Okay, let's go on to the next slide. And it's all about a monkey. Okay, now listen to me please. Monkeys are clever mammals that can solve problems and hold things in their hands. They live in groups called troops. Monkeys eat plants, birds, small animals, and insects. Most of them live in the forest. Okay, can't you guess? Where is the habitat? Okay, nice. Most of them live in a forest. Ya, sebagian besar dari mereka tinggal di hutan. What are their food? The answer is monkeys eat plants, bird eggs, small animals, and insects. Yang artinya monyet memakan tanaman, telur burung, binatang-binatang kecil, dan serangga. Then, what are their activity? Apa aktivitasnya? You can see from the text that they live in groups called troops. Artinya, mereka tinggal secara berkelompok seperti pasukan-pasukan kerang. Lalu, what are the characteristics? The answer is, monkeys are clever mammals that can solve problems and hold things in their hands. Artinya, monyet adalah binatang yang cerdas yang bisa menyelesaikan masalah dan bisa memegang makanan di tangan mereka. Okay, have you already understood? Nice. Let's go on to the next. Well, now look at this table. You can see it on your textbook, page 89. From this table, you can see number one has been done for you. So you just do the rest. Baik anak-anak, setelah kalian mendengarkan penjelasan Bu Windy tadi, sekarang waktunya kalian menuliskan informasi-informasi yang kalian dapatkan ke dalam tabel ini seperti contoh. Jadi hanya tinggal menuliskan habitatnya apa, foodnya apa, activity-nya apa, dan karakteristiknya apa. Okay, now it's time for you to do the task. Let's write. Find three different animals, then describe them one by one. So please, temukan tiga hewan yang berbeda, boleh hewan apa aja, lalu tuliskan deskripsinya seperti contoh yang diberikan. Di sini contohnya ada rabbits ya, tentang kelinci. Okay, you can take a look at on your textbook, page 90. If you find difficulties, you can take a look at on your dictionary or ask me. Okay, students, I think that's it our class today. Don't forget to watch part 2 on my next video. See you and bye-bye!